الو محمد اسمع كل اشي جاهز حكون في الساعة 4 في المطار اها اها مدخل رقم 5 لا 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 ايوه على اللغة وعليكم السلام
I'm sorry, gentlemen, but you must buckle your seatbelts.
I have mine.
Don't touch me, infidel.
Thank you.
Good. Yes, Mohammed.
You think we are doing the right thing?
I don't understand. A man like you was about to graduate from the University of Madrid asking such a question. If you don't have faith to what we are doing, why you are coming with me?
Because of the hatred they have for our kind. The Spaniard deported me. Deport me where? Because of the wars, I had no homeland no more.
I was once like you, Mohammed. I lost everything. You know, there are still many like us. Hey, don't worry. It takes time, but we'll get our rights.
That's true. Allahu Akbar. I'll be right back.
Shouldn't do that. How old are you?
Six.
Thank you.
filthy Arab.
What is the purpose of your trip, gentlemen?
We are just visiting friends.
For how long?
A month.
Have a nice visit.
Thank you.
US Air Flight 21, now departing for San Jose and San Francisco. Mr. George Benedict, please report to the information desk. Attention, attention. Air France départ pour New York. Paris et Rome. Attenzione,
sir.
Attenzione.
Excuse me, sir.
All'Italia.
You dropped your wallet.
Thank you.
Attention. Attention, ladies and gentlemen. Flight 21, now departing for New York, Paris, and Rome. All arrivals and departures are limited to 3-minute parking. All arrivals and departures are limited to 3-minute parking.
Have you been here in Los Angeles before, Abdul?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
An old friend of yours lives here.
Yeah, I know. Hack Stone. I'll deal with him later.
We have 2 meeting places, one here and the other at an ocean beach house.
Good.
Marhaba.
Ahlan wa sahlan. Kifak hal?
It's an honor
to meet you, Abdul.
Thank you. Yes, you've done much for our cause. Now the woman, Aziza, who's part of our team, has secured a location outside of the city where you will hold the target hostage.
I see. Has food, water, and communication been set up?
I'll take care of that, sir. After the strike, we'll have change of clothes for you in the van.
Great. What about arms and ammunition?
There are guns in the van and also more at the location.
Good. What else?
I have made a videotape of the villa where the target is staying.
Good. Let's see.
The target always travels with three bodyguards. The villa is surrounded by security people.
I have planned this operation according to my orders.
I know the orders, Abbas. See, I planned it. Okay, I'm here to take complete charge of the operation. So, I know when we go and how. As you see, the target is heavily guarded. We must wait until she leaves the villa tomorrow. Then we strike. Everything is clear? So, you are all excused, gentlemen, for now.
When I think I might have you for the first time, you decked me, Hack. Wow.
You're doing good, Billy. You keep it up. You'll be able to whip my butt. Let's have some coffee. Come on, Clay.
Leg all right, Bill?
Yeah, fine. Who are these guys?
Those characters. Part of a Middle East covert group I was involved with for about 2 years, matter of fact.
Who's the dude with the burnous?
Oh, this guy.
Yeah.
That was my pal, Abdul. We did a lot of secret missions together. They're another fun things, if you know what I mean.
He looks pretty tough.
Yeah, I'm sure he'd agree with you on that.
Really?
Yeah, Abdul was a pretty mean character. Pretty tough. He's my best friend. Once saved my life. This character over here just wanted to prolong it for some crazy cause that I don't really understand or know about.
Where is he now?
In the Middle East. Dead, I hope.
Wait a minute. You said he was a friend of yours.
Yeah, he was my best friend. But as long as he's alive, my life is always on the edge.
I don't get it. Why?
Well, there was a time we captured four of the enemy. He wanted to execute him on the spot.
And I decided that we should bring him in to camp. And, of course, he didn't like that too much.
Unfortunately, two of them escaped that night, back to his home where he lived, and killed his wife and kids. And obviously, he blamed me for my American sense of justice. And he swore that one day he'd come back and he'd kill me.
I hope he's dead too, Hack. I wouldn't want to meet up with a character like that.
Neither would I.
Yeah, I'm through with that kind of fight now. It's all hands and feet. I'm teaching you guys how to defend yourselves against your wives.
Hey, I gotta get a move on. We're getting a special briefing today.
Yeah, what's up?
A VIP is coming to town to do some shopping on Rodale Drive.
Ah, the working class, huh?
Right. Well, whoever it is, we sure are beefing up security.
Yes? Ooh. Hey, you must be moving up in the world, pal. It's Captain Stills of the LAPD.
Derek on line 5, Captain Stills.
Oh, Bill. I want you to move your ass to Rodeo Drive. This thing is jumping. The FBI's getting kind of nervous about our VIP visitor. You got that? You move your ass to Rodeo Drive and you stay there.
Right, Captain. See you, Hack.
Yeah, take care.
Not as good as English. What do you think?
Where's England?
Hey, Gunt!
Hi, Bruce, my man! I got something hot for you today.
Hey, Gandhi, I heard your wife won the California lottery.
And I haven't seen her since.
Ah, that's cool. She was ugly anyway. So what you got today?
I got this hot watch for you.
Ooh, it's hot. And it's a couple minutes slow.
Bruce, be careful. The cops are all over the place today.
I know. I've never seen so many cops in Beverly Hills. What is it, some kind of summit meeting or something?
Don't ask me. I'm just an Indian.
50?
50!
All right. Okay now. Be cool.
Get ready. They're coming. Hussein, don't lose it.
Here's 100. Keep the change.
Thanks, lady.
Okay, I got you.
Hey, man, what
come
are you
on, come
doing,
on.
Man, what are you
spread
doing?
The legs.
Hey, man, I live around here.
So do
this
I.
This is my neighborhood. Come on,
bullshit.
Man.
Bullshit.
Shopping, honey.
Okay.
Can I help you, gentlemen?
Around the way.
Shit, man, what are
I'm
you
headed
doing?
Down 4th Street.
You're gonna get us killed!
Towards the tunnel.
Shit. I should have listened to my astrologist. This thing bad today. Right?
Thank you.
Excuse me, sir. The people that got out of that van, did you see where they went?
Yeah, they were gotten into a large white limo.
Are you sure?
I'm sure.
Thanks, Pops. This is car 69. I have positive ID on kidnapper's van. Suspects left in white limo.
Ali, tie it up over there.
Tie it up over there, Ali. Move!
Finish this job. I have another personal escort to settle in Los Angeles. Don't you worry. Okay?
Good afternoon. This is Tony Mona with a special report. This afternoon, the president's daughter was kidnapped by a group of Middle East terrorists. Please stay tuned to this station for further updates.
Look, miss, these are our demands. I want you to read them clearly into the tape recorder. No funny business, okay?
No, my father can't comply with those demands. It's not possible. Dick.
Go ahead.
We will release the president's daughter after the president of the United States has ordered the Israelis to release 55 of our political brothers. If the president does not meet these demands, his daughter Margaret will die.
Yeah.
You've got 12 hours.
Tony Moda.
Hello, TV station?
Yes, it is.
Okay, this is a message from President's daughter. Are you ready?
Hold on. Get this on tape. Go ahead.
Okay.
We will release the president's daughter after the president of the United States has ordered the Israelis to release 55 of our...
Lieutenant Lennon here.
Get a trace on the location of the call, Lenny.
We'll pull a trace on it.
Harder.
A super trace.
Give me that damn phone. Get a fucking super trace. Asshole. Got it? Good. I know I'm gonna lose my pension. I knew something like this would happen.
Well, Captain, the president's daughter wasn't on the line long enough for us to get a good trace or pinpoint the exact location.
Well, what about a general location?
Somewhere near the ocean.
They're now showing you a tape of the actual kidnapping of the president's daughter by her Middle East captors.
Security camera. Why we didn't kill it before?
I don't know, Abdul.
Yes, I'm watching the goddamn news. What are you watching, a porno movie?
Daughter was kidnapped.
White House Press Secretary George McCann said today, and I quote, "The president has already called a meeting of his security people to take the necessary steps to rescue his daughter, Margaret." End of quote. The president's daughter is being held hostage by a group of Middle East terrorists. Press Secretary McCann continued by saying, "The president will call in the military if necessary." The entire nation is left in suspense over the safety of the president's daughter, Margaret.
Damn it.
In the meantime, the Los Angeles police chief has put Captain Marion Stills of the LAPD in charge of the case. In this reporter's opinion, Captain Stills really has his work cut out for him. Here again are the terrorist demands.
We will release the president's daughter after the president of the United States has ordered the Israelis to release 55 of our political brothers. If the president does not meet these demands, his daughter Margaret will die. You've got 12 hours.
That was the voice of the president's daughter delivering the terrorist demands.
Yes, I thank you, Harry, but believe me when I tell you, I have bigger problems right now. Let's talk about it next Tuesday, and I thank you. Uh-huh. How the hell did this happen, gentlemen? I'm always caught up in these damn Middle East conflicts. Now they got my daughter. I want to know what the hell we're doing about it.
Mr. President, we have an actual location where your daughter's being held. We have ground and air crew looking for a white limousine, the car they all escaped in.
Would you tell me what an actual location means, son? This is my daughter.
Mr. President, we're doing all we can. We will get your daughter back.
I know you will. I know you will, and I appreciate it. Now, if you gentlemen will excuse me, I have to talk to the Prime Minister of Israel. And that will be all.
Now, this is Chopper 14. I think I've spotted the white limo out here by the old meat factory.
10-4, Chopper.
Tony Moda. Yes, Crystal.
The terrorists have the president's daughter in the old bean factory off the 101.
Yes. Fabulous. Fantastic. Thanks, hon. The check's in the mail.
Red alert, 1908. Red alert, 1909. Red alert, 1901.
only here to negotiate.
Doctor gonna be here soon.
Doctor, I'm afraid.
Don't be. I'm here.
Cars 17, 18, 11, and 12 proceed to the old bean factory off the 101. Cars 24, 27, 31 move in on the old bean factory off of 101.
They want you as long as you have President Dollar.
Police shoot everywhere!
Get back to the office!
All right, what the hell do we have here?
You're up here on the third floor, near the window.
Abdul, some policemen have come out. They're looking at us.
Something wrong. I don't like it, Mohammed.
Have all the backups arrived yet?
Yes, sir.
Shot in my back. Now gather around here, man. Let's see what we figure out what to do about these assholes. Now, I want you to show me the exact location of that goddamn room.
It's right there, sir.
Exact?
Yes, sir.
Did you check that out?
Yes.
Now for the good news. The Honorable President has declared we cannot fire a single goddamn shot.
Making it awfully hard for us.
Tell me about it. Will you close the fucking doors? Tight! Assholes. Thank God I got a pension coming up. Close that fucking door! Get your fucking head shot off. Close it!
I understand, Mr. Prime Minister, but you must also understand, I do not have 24 hours. It's a question of my daughter's life. I have just a few hours to deal with these people. Yes, sir, I know you have a daughter. And I would sincerely hope that when you come to a decision, you will get back to me just as soon as you possibly can. Thank you. Shalom. Howard, get a hold of the FBI. You have them tell those terrorists we're waiting for a final word from Israel. I'm not going to wait much longer. Now you do that. Yes, hello. It's the President. Would you please get me Marine Corps General Kyle Gray in Virginia? If he's not in his home, you try his country club. It's quite important you do that for me, will you? It's the President. Thank you.
Operator, give me the police department. Tell them we got the president's daughter. Hey, look, back off or I kill the girl.
Where's that undercover man, that damned, goddamn Derek?
Right here, sir.
What the hell is that outfit you're wearing?
He said it was all right, sir.
Well, you know I got no taste. Jesus. It's like he got on Gucci's on 7th.
Go in, sir.
Who is it?
The terrorist. You, Derek.
Yeah, Derek here.
We've got a terrorist call on line 5.
Patch him through.
I have a man badly wounded. I need a doctor.
Now!
Hey, listen. If you don't send doctor right away, I'll cut the girl in 2 pieces.
You got it? No way. You'll just make the doctor another hostage.
If you don't get me a doctor, I'll kill the girl and throw out the window. You hear me?
All right, all right. We'll send in a paramedic. All right, give me a paramedic's outfit. I'm going in there.
Bill, why you?
Because somebody's got to do it. And I've had some medical training.
Here you are, sir.
I want to put a bug on you, and I want to spy on your every single movement. We'll get somebody in there to help you. Now move it.
Gotcha.
Move it!
Yes, Carl, yes. Well, thank you. I assume you know what's been happening. I need some military help here.
Yes, I saw it on the news. I'm sorry. But, Mr. President, I have the man for you. 2 years on covert operations in the Middle East. Fighting on our side, of course.
What's his name, and how do I get a hold of him?
His name is Hack Stone. You should remember, Mr. President. After all, you pinned the Medal of Honor on him.
Yes, I do remember that. Hack Stone. Well, he'll be our man. Activate him immediately and put him on this thing. I thank you, Carl. Hack Stone.
How about that, Ned?
Boy, that's terrific, son. I gotta tell you. I'm proud of you. Well, miss, I guess you can tell where this boy gets his talent.
Teacher said he might even skip a grade. How about that, Dad?
How about that? That's great. Why don't you go put your gi on and show your mommy how good you look, huh?
Okay, Dad.
Ha, ha. Ha, ha, I can tell now where he gets his brains and his looks.
Now, don't you ever forget it.
No, me, I wouldn't forget that.
Sweetheart, wouldn't you love to just go wash up?
That bad, huh? Well, we'll forget this.
Hack Stone Studio. Just a minute. It's Washington. It's for you.
Hello?
Hack, General Gray here.
Yes, General. How are you doing?
Fine, Hack. Just fine. I suppose you know what's going on.
Yes, sir.
Hack? Do you know there's some bad guys in the Middle East that have got a price on your head?
Yeah. And the bad guys just showed up in Beverly Hills.
Right. Hack, I think this job is for you.
Like this bud's for you, huh? Why me?
Because you were a friend of this Abdul guy. And I think you're the only one that can handle the son of a bitch.
I'm retired. I'm a private citizen now. I just,
Not anymore. But, Hack, it's your decision.
Well, I'm not too good at making decisions, sir. Last one I made got me in trouble. But I guess I'm your man.
Great, great. Report to Captain Stills, LAPD. He has all the details. And, Hack, don't fail me.
I'll try not to, sir.
Good luck, Hack.
Thank you, sir.
Let's come. Do you have to go?
It's rock and roll, honey.
Why?
Don't you worry about anything. Hack don't kill that easy.
Step on it, Jimmy boy. Come on, girls, let's get set. I'm going in to talk to Captain Stills, and for God's sake, don't get shot.
Aziza, Aziza, look. The television people are taking the picture of us.
Good. That means the President of the United States will know we mean business.
Get a shot of that third story window. That's where the action is. And let's get some shots of these cops. I think there's going to be a shootout.
What about Captain Stills?
He's going to give us an interview.
Here he comes now.
All right. All right. I have a statement for you. LaMotta, how come you're always the first to arrive? You got somebody tipping you off?
I have a crystal ball, sir.
Well, I certainly hope so. Get a glimpse of your pension, now you need the damn glasses to read it, huh? Well, here's the statement. Oh, don't run that camera when I'm smoking. As you're all aware, the president's daughter is being held hostage by a terrorist group inside that building. They have presented their demands, which are that the Israelis must free 55 of their politicals, or they have threatened to assassinate the president's daughter. The president of the United States is negotiating, as I speak, with the prime minister of Israel. Damned airplanes. Also, unfortunately, we've had several setbacks in our attempt to rescue them.
But, Captain Stills...
Cut off! LaMotta, why don't you open an Italian restaurant? Huh?
Jesus. Did you get that?
Sure did.
What a bastard.
You're still there.
Your chief, this is Detective Buck.
Through his shoulder. He'll be all right for now. But he'd be better off in a hospital.
Shut up.
Okay. I'd like to see the president's daughter.
Why?
I'd like to assure the police she's okay.
Off!
is this? And Mike.
Listen to me. I told you, we are not playing games here. This is your last mistake. Next time the girl dies.
God help us.
Do you think you are the only people ready to die for a cause? You are trying to trick us. Now your man dies!
You asshole! You're prepared to die in here. So don't provoke us if you want her alive. Is that clear?
Execute him!
Take him out and finish him!
Nice of you to call, General. Well, that's the situation, yes, sir. Well, we need all the help we can get. I think it's best to keep it quiet now. Right? I understand. Thank you for calling, General. Sir. Be a son of a bitch.
What's up, Captain?
They've called in the fucking Marines.
The Marines?
Not all of them, dummy. Just one. One fucking Marine. Christ.
He's coming.
Please be patient. As soon as anything develops, we'll let you know.
Captain Still?
Yeah.
What is Hackstone's first move?
Why don't you look in your crystal ball?
And if that fails?
Then we'll need your crystal ball. Both of them.
He's still a bastard. Get a shot up there.
The helicopter's landing.
It's done, all right. Get a close-up of him as he runs by.
Aziz, hand me the phone. President of the United States brought in an old enemy.
Yes, I know. He is the enemy.
I want him dead. But I want to do it.
You do your own mission, and I'll stop Hackstone.
Right.
Where is that goddamn gyrene?
Aye, Skipper.
Skipper? Yeah. Those fuckers and their fanatics. Ready to die for a cause.
That's right, Captain. Just like you and me.
Huh?
ready to die for what they believe in.
Huh?
I told the president yesterday I felt if we gave in to those terrorists that those boys would try to run the whole show.
Yeah, and do away with our way of justice and my friggin' pension.
Gee, that's too bad.
And did the president agree with you?
He always does.
Always does, huh? I know that some shithead bastard tyrant is behind all this.
Yeah. Does a bear shit in the woods?
I hate tyrants. Will somebody please show this fucking Marine where the terrorists are?
Yes, sir, boss.
Don't worry about Axton. We have his wife and his son here at the beach house.
Good. Now we force his hand.
Billings. It's me, Stone. Yeah, Stone here.
Remember my promise, Hank? You will never come out of this alive. I swear it by my honor.
Abdul, why don't you just chill out? You ain't got a chance in hell, and you know it.
No, you won't stop me. Not if you want to see your wife and son back again.
Captain, I gotta get out of here.
What's up?
The terrorists have just grabbed my wife and kid, and if I stay on this job, they're gonna kill me sure as hell, just like they did Bill Derrick.
Look, Stone, we'll get the bastard who did it, and we'll get your family back.
All the hell you will. You don't know this Abdul character like I do. He kills and he likes it.
You just hold on, Stone.
Hold on, shit. This ain't my fight and it ain't my decision. I didn't ask to be reactivated. You remember one thing. You remember well. I'm a private citizen.
You hold on, Stone. Now, the private citizen is the law. Lawmakers might make the law and assholes like me might enforce them. But it's the duty of the private citizen to uphold the law. There is no law if the private citizen doesn't uphold it. You got that? Shit.
Bullshit.
Captain, helicopter 16 spotted a woman and a kid being hustled into a Malibu beach house by some suspicious-looking characters.
Got a chopper here and a double. You hold on there, Stone. You're under executive orders. You cannot leave here. But we can, my men and I. And we will find your family and rescue them, so help me God.
Look, Captain, I know Abdul. His bunch, they fight real dirty. And the only way you're gonna whip their ass is fight dirtier than they are.
I just hope that one morning we don't wake up and realize we are dirtier.
You just bring back my family.
You can count on it, Marie.
I hope so.
That was a little Harry in there for me.
Yeah, it was Harry. Well, Stone was just wrestling with the consequences of his decision.
Well, he seems like a man of principle.
Yes, of course. He loves his family. He loves his country.
You just have to remind him of his duties, which is an extension of his principle.
That's very well put, Lenny. Now let's haul ass and find his family.
Some guy, you're Captain Stills.
You better believe it. Captain Stills just stuck his neck out for you.
How's that?
Look, if the chief finds out the captain deserted his post to rescue your family, chief, throw him off the force. Goodbye, Finch.
I was right. He is a nice guy. You don't work too hard.
Doctor.
What?
The helicopter took off with a black man in it.
That's a decoy. I know, Hank. Now he'll make his move.
Hussein, tie it up again.
Namu on Munchen Heiser! Hey, one! Yalla, MC!
don't you make some tea?
American tea?
Right.
Personal revenge with Hackstone doesn't get us all killed.
Why is that dog barking?
I'll go take a look.
I made my day.
Mrs. Stone. I'm Officer Leonard, LAPD.
Oh, thank God. Untie me, please.
Here. Just a minute.
Oh, my baby.
Give me the boy. Come, give me the boy. Right. Let me help you.
Oh, Jamie, it's going to be all right.
Come on, it's all right. It's okay now. Come on, guys.
Come on, we're going to go home.
Come on,
now.
Let's go.
Alley up, sweetheart.
Alley up.
Thank you.
are you doing? Please don't kill me. What are you doing to me? What are you doing? Where are you taking me? No! What are you doing to me?
Shut up!
Make them like they used to.
Help me! Help me!
Azize! Ali! Muhammad! Hussein!
Let her go, man! They're all dead, Abdul! Give up!
If they are all dead, then she is dead too.
Help me! Help me! Help me! Please help me!
Back off or she dies!
Don't be crazy, man. I'm your friend. I can walk you out of here, and no one will hurt you, I promise you.
Walk out of here with the executioner of my wife and children? Are you crazy or what? Heck, if my cause is lost, I'm a dead man. Dead man, don't walk! It wasn't your bad decision. It was your government last and see in the Middle East. You should know that. You can't stop me.
Come on, man, don't be an asshole. Still hiding behind a woman, huh?
You want it?
It's all madness.
Ah, come on, guys. All we want is an interview.
Keep the camera on her.
All clear. All clear. The president's daughter is safe. All units return to home base. Good job, everybody.